guys, Dagan here from PMTVUK with a John Mayer gear guide. Now, before you start giving me loads and loads of grief, looking right now going, well, no, that's just definitely not. A couple of things. The first, I'm just one person in a guitar store in the UK. I haven't got access to 1964 Strats, original Klon Centaurs, original TS-808s, $220,000 Dumble amps, two rocks, Alejandro modded cabs. I'm working with what we've got here. It's an amazing setup that I believe gets you almost close to that iconic sound. However, the gear he uses is very rare, very expensive, and he's allowed to. He makes lots of money by making incredible music. I've been a Mayer fan for years and years and years, so this is as close as I can get right now, and I'll go through everything explaining. Like, I know he doesn't use a TS-9, but yes, we'll get to that later, get that shortly. And secondly, I haven't got Mayer's beautiful digits. These hands are my own. They're 28 years old, and I consider them okay. I've been a fan of Mayer for long enough to know certain sounds and songs, definitely songs, but I'll never have his touch, I'll never have his sound, so I'm not 100% there, okay? But this is what I'm working with right now, what we have, to hopefully show you guys what you can get close to the sound of John Mayer. And if you disagree, that's fine. This is just a bit of fun. I was asked if I wanted to do a John Mayer gear guide, and I jumped at the chance because I adore that man. He's got amazing tone, amazing songs, and he's one hell of a player. And if you want to add anything, please comment down below what I should change and what we should do next time and help others out. People wanting help, look in the comments, for lots of people probably telling me I'm wrong. But yeah, everyone help each other out, okay? It's just a bit of fun. So in this video, I'm going to talk about the guitars he's used over the years, the amps he uses, the effects he uses, and why he uses certain things. He's changed a lot over the years. Amp setup, pedals, there's so many different variants of pedal boards, whether it's with the trio himself, Dead and Company, and everything in between. So the guitars, the amps, the pedals. I have to give one little shout out as well. If you're an absolute gear nerd like myself and adore John Mayer, check out John Mayer Gear on Instagram for the most in-depth, amazing photographs and information of the gear Mr. John Mayer uses. It's an incredible, incredible Instagram page, so check that out. It's helped me a lot. And yes, let's get down to business, what I'm doing today. So I'm going to talk about guitars last because there's more guitars than what I have everything else, okay? I've got the Silver Sky right now, John's latest signature guitar. I'm gonna talk about the Stevie Ray Vaughan, which was his first ever guitar. I've actually got my own Fender Strat Deluxe in the corner there, which has Big Dipper pickups in the neck and the middle. And I'm gonna rock a 62 Custom Shop Strat as well to show you what the pickups sound like, so you can tell the differences between, do the Big Dipper pickups sound different to what the Silver Sky pickups sound like? John Mayer doesn't actually use the Big Dipper pickups in any of his guitars. So will his 64 Strat sound more similar to the 62 Custom Shop? Who knows, you'll decide later on. So, amp setup, I'm using a Fender Deluxe Reverb amp, a fantastic Fender amplifier, and John is known to rock Fender amps. He loves Fender amps because his tone is very clean with lots of headroom. He gets his drives from pedals, which I'll talk about shortly. So he's always been a Fender guy when it comes to amps in small stages. Obviously, he's got his two rocks. He used to use custom reverbs. Two Rock is an amazing amp company, a boutique handmade amp company from California. They make amazing amplifiers. I had one a couple of years ago and I couldn't really get the John Mayer sound. I found that, obviously it wasn't the big expensive John Mayer one, you get more akin to a Fender than the Two Rock to get the John Mayer sound. But anyways, he's got his big fancy signature Two Rock heads and his Dumbles, a steel string singer, which he uses a lot, and he's got overdrive specials and everything in between. So they're very expensive. So what I'd use right now is a Fender Deluxe Reverb because I know he likes them. Even though, for the nerds out there, I know all of his Fender amps are modified by Alessandro, who make his 2x12s with neodymium magnet speakers in. Just for the nerds out there, I know all his are vintage and modified and lovely. This is what I've got right now, okay? I'm in a guitar store. Have fun. Signal chain-wise, I can't get my hands on a Keeley Katana boost pedal. John has a few boost pedals in his chain to either boost the signal for a solo or to boost amps, like stack, not amps, pedals, going into an amplifier. So I've got this TC Electronic Spark, which is the closest thing I can find online to a Keeley Katana boost pedal, which just has one control. And that's gonna be used at the front of this to boost these effects later on. TS-9, John could do an entire set on an Ibanez Tube Screamer. It's the only drive pedal he needs. He prefers the TS-808 and the TS-10. Most notably the TS-10, which is the one that came around in the 80s. Kind of a vintage thing, very plasticky 80s looking pedal, not as cool and sought after as the 808 or the TS-9. But my TS-808 is currently stuck in a DPD depot just up the road, so I had to use my little daft gold TS-9 for this video. The tone will be there. Moving along, he always stacks his pedals. He's always got two drive pedals, and he chops and changes between them because it does sound different whether you rock a Choose Humor first or after something like a Klon. This is a Seriatone Centura. A beautiful pedal. I was going to use Electroharmonic Soul Food, which is a great Klon-sounding pedal, but I thought I'd use the big guns and rock out my Centura for this video. The Klon Centaur is a mythical pedal from many years ago. There's a lot of hype. It's very expensive. Does it do a lot? Not really, but it kind of brings everything up and opens the frequencies of your guitar sound. But I'm not here to talk about what this does. I'm talking about the fact that it's here. And at the end of the signal, he enjoys a good delay pedal. The Aquapus Mark I has been on his board for many, many years. A great sounding delay pedal by Way Huge. This is the latest variant of the Way Huge Smalls Aquapus. And finally, the Strymon Flint. Now, he's always ever used amp reverb, spring reverb in his lovely amplifiers. His T-Rocks have them, his Dumbbells can have a line out to them. But when he brought out the J-Mod head with PRS, it didn't have a reverb in. And he was seen using the Flint a lot, and I had a Flint in the cabinet downstairs, and I was like, I'm going to use a Strymon Flint for a beautiful reverb in this video. I haven't got it on right now, I'll do it later to show you the difference between the Fender Spring and the Flint. But for now, that is the Flint, and that is why I have this setup. He has lots more pedals. He has Boss OC3s, he has Adrenaline pedals to get that amazing sound on, what's the song called again? What's the song called, Alex?
Can't Trust Myself.
I Can't Trust Myself Without Loving You. To get that lovely kind of wah effect, he uses the Qtron. Besides this delay, he's got some dramatically amazing, very expensive handmade delay pedals by Pete Cornish. He enjoys a Boss TU-2 as a tuner. The wah pedals he uses are great. Again, check out John Mayer Gear for really detailed descriptions of what he uses and all of his guitars. But for now, this is what I'm using, and I'm currently stacking the drives together. The TS-1 is going into the Klon. And it sounds great, like I said. To get the John Mayer sound, get an amp. His amps are very high watt amps to get a lot of headroom, and he gets his drives from his Klons and his modified Keeley or Analog Man blues driver pedals. You won't get too much difference between the TS-9 and the TS-808. This has a bit more mid-range bite. But it sounds great. Everything is mic'd up with an Aston Stealth. I know people like knowing all the little ins and outs, especially in a video like this. I'm using Tuatec cables. Everything's powered by an MXR ISO brick. Zoom H6 to record it all. I'm using a Hawk pick. John Mayer famously uses blue chip. Well, not famously. He's actually said he doesn't endorse these picks because it's like £40 for a guitar pick, what he uses, the blue chip picks. But it does something for him and he can afford it, so it's fine. But he always says he uses the green and yellow Tortex picks for years. These expensive ones are just daft, but if you can't afford it, do it. But yes, Aston Stealth, Tuatec cables, ISO brick. Let's talk about the first guitar John's known for now, the Stevie Ray Vaughan Signature Strat. The Stevie Ray Vaughan Strat. This guitar is almost these days as associated with Mayer in certain circles, especially bluesy circles, as his signature Strat and the Silver Sky now, because back in 1996, Mayer got himself a lovely Stevie Ray Vaughan Stratocaster. These days, not much of the concoction has changed. Older body, a big oval-shaped maple neck with a Pow Ferro fingerboard. I believe it's always had Pow Ferro, which is awesome to know. And most importantly, Texas Special pickups, which are the Stevie Ray Vaughan thing and the Mayer thing. Everyone knows that Stevie Ray Vaughan is a huge inspiration to Mr. Mayer. People say he's a ripoff. I don't think he's a ripoff. I think what do you do as a guitar player? You take your idols and you try and emulate them. No one can emulate their idols. And in that way, you get your own sound by amalgamating all your idols that you can't sound like. And you sound like you. And that is what John's done. But he does wear the fact that he loves Stevie Ray Vaughan on his sleeve. He's even got a tattoo. And in 1996, he bought the Stevie Ray Vaughan signature Strat. He's got a tortoiseshell pickguard on his though, and a lot of people think that his 64 Strat, his the one he played a lot from 2005, 2006 on the Continuum Tour onwards. He's probably most associated with that Sunburst Relic Strat, which is actually a 64 Strat. People think that's his Stevie Ray Vaughan Strat Relic. It's definitely not. His Stevie Strat is very much in his care. It's got a poly finish anyways, it doesn't relic like that. But anyways, another big thing is the Texas Special pickups. There's a myth that... There's a myth that his pickups were broken, and that's where the Big Dippers came from, with that mid-scoop. Mayer's sound comes from that mid-scoop, and you will hear Big Dippers soon in my Strat over there. But that can't be right. You can't have mythical broken pickups. That's almost as mythical as Klon's being amazing and Dumble's being amazing. Granted, we buy them. That's my Centura, but I don't think that's the case. I think it's all in his fingers and in the gear that he uses. And to be fair, he sounds like him no matter what he plays. Apparently, only his signature Strat, which you rarely played unless it was at Stevie Ray Vaughan's tribute concert. Wait, that was Stevie's guitar. Ignore that. None of his guitars had the Big Dipper pickups in. The black one didn't, his 64 hasn't, the rest of them hasn't. So yeah, Big Dippers are kind of just a thing, so apparently the broken Texas Specials aren't really a thing. But John used this guitar all through Berkeley. It's kind of what he played on, inside once out, and room for squares, and it's been seen plenty of times since. Let's hear it with some pedals on and off now. So, this is the lovely clean sound I've got. I'm not going to play too many Mayer songs, even though I really want to, because copyright will absolutely have my backside. But you know, you can do it yourself. If you want to learn how to play like Mayer, get yourself to PMTVUK on YouTube and check out Lee Fuge's top tips to sound like John Mayer. I should have watched that before I did this. I've seen it, don't worry. Now with his Klon and his Tube Screamer, this is where he gets most of his drive from, like I said, but Klons are usually known to be a always on pedal, sorry Flint, an always on pedal, where you keep the gain down. That is not the case with Mayer. This is with a gain at 10 o'clock. And it's still a bit clean. There's a bit more to it, but I've seen the gain a quarter of the way up on Mayer's board on that John Mayer gear page. Kind of Mary, but a lot of the time he gets his gain from the TS-10, TS-808, and I've got a TS-9 because I couldn't get one. So we get that light overdrive. That wasn't played with that much distortion, but it sounds good regardless, so I thought I'd play some Mayer. And what do you do when you boost them? Let's turn on our Keeley Katana, which is a spark. Get a bit more bite, don't we? Like I say, he's always got two Keeley Katanas on, one at the front to boost the signal going into the drive pedals, and one at the end of the chain, usually to boost the signal before solos and whatnot. So let's hit all three on together, because we can. So that is some specs and sounds on the Stevie, why he used it, when he used it, and this kind of evolved that spec and look into his signature guitar with the Big Dippers in. Now let's talk about that now. Big Dipper pickups, and that was a really iffy rendition of Helpless. Hopefully I'll get through copyright by playing it wrong, but anyways, these are Big Dipper pickups. Can you tell the difference between this and the Texas Specials? I sure can. Do one sound more Mary than the other? Not particularly. They're just different sounding Strat pickups. Now, they never made these off the shelf, unfortunately, which is daft because I think that they would have sold like hotcakes. If Paul Reed Smith, if you're watching this right now, for some weird reason, please sell the Silver Sky pickups by themselves because everyone will buy them. Everyone will buy them, including me. My mate was selling a John Mayer signature guitar, and I convinced him he'll make more money if he sold it in bits. And he did, and I bought the pickups. That's the only reason I ever sold them, so sorry, Mark, if you're watching this. But yes, Big Dipper neck pickup and middle pickup, not the bridge, ignore the bridge, that's just for my own novelty. So, Big Dipper pickups. John Strat was released in 2006. His first thing with Fender, he was chuffed to bits. The Stevie Ray Vaughan Strat took a backseat. He had his signature guitar with his signature pickups in. The Big Dipper pickups, famous for having a mid-scoop. That broken sound, apparently, on the Stevie Ray Vaughan Strat. Does it sound very mid-scoop to you? Kind of sounds like mid-scoop to me. Fender amps have a natural mid-scoop anyways, as the Dumbles. So this is all just words and it's in his fingers. This is just for a bit of fun on YouTube, isn't it? But anyways, let's hear it without all that drive. Just the Fender Deluxe Reverb with the Big Dipper pickups. Turn the clone on. So you can tell there, it kind of adds a bit of something. Kind of doesn't take away that mid pullness? Mid pullness, what on earth is that? But anyways. When he just wants a little bit extra, he turns on the clone or a tube screamer with the gain down. Like I said, Mayer could rock an entire set with only a tube screamer. Stacked again. But he scarfs in the way. So I've been saying for a while that the Big Dippers don't sound like anything like the Texas Specials, but for me there's one sound which it does really well, and it's a sound which has became probably most recently the most played song in guitar stores that's ever been, and that is of course this. What do you think? Has that got the slow dancing sound position too on those guys? It's certainly got the snap, hasn't it? Or, what I always say, is it just in our heads as guitarists to think that you need the Big Dipper pickups to sound like Mayer, even though that song wasn't recorded with Big Dipper pickups, and it's ridiculous. So he used this 64 Strat and his signature Strat until the black one came out. The black one was his first custom shop guitar in 2006, 2008, I think. John Mayer gear page. Go to that and check it out. It was a custom shop by John Cruz. An amazing guitar, black relic, beautiful thing. And he used that alongside his 64 Strat and his signature Strat. And now I'm going to talk about this 62 Journeyman. This is a Fender 1962 reissue from the custom shop. It's an amazing guitar and very Mayer-y. It's an early 60s Strat, but it's not kind of tied to him to any way. So does that mean you can't sound like John Mayer with it? I mean, yes, you haven't got his fingers. That's the answer to that one. But I'm kind of saying, will any Fender Strat with a rosewood board kind of fit the ilk of John Mayer? And I believe so. If you get that single coil loveliness, you haven't got to have scoop pickups or anything. Don't be as daft as me and spend lots of money on daft pickups. The pedals and the amp do a lot as well. Have a clean amp with a lot of headroom. And has it even got to be a Strat? I played Edge of Desire there, and that was famously played live for years on a Gibson SG. And, well, now he plays it on a PRS because he's all PRS-y, isn't he? So that's played on an SG. He used to play it back in the day. No, that was Assassin. He played Assassin on a Music Man Reflex, I think. And he still sounded exactly like John Mayer. That's kind of how it works, but I thought it's the closest thing I can get to his 64 Strat, a 62 reissue. Fender don't even make a 62 Strat. 64 Strat, I meant, sorry. And I've got the Aquapus on. Which is a beautiful analog sounding delay pedal that John likes to use every now and then. But like I say, there's lots more to John's rig than just this. These are kind of like the simplest ones. And that bodes the question, is this video pointless? You can have all the gear and no idea, which is how I live my life most of the time, especially when it comes to sounding like John Mayer. This video is not pointless. Chatting about gear and sharing stories and sharing experiences of playing gear to sound like your idols is what this is all about. So like I said, comment down below all the kind of fun you want. And this is available at your local store. I'm in PMT Newcastle right now and all this is available right here. And you can only sound like John Mayer with his hands. Granted, you can have as many tips as you want. Like I say, watch Lee Fuge's video on how to sound like John Mayer on our lovely channel. You might be watching this thinking he sounds nothing like John Mayer. Sounds damn good at me, but it could just be the fact that I really enjoy that music. This is a 62 Strat, and John was with Fender, playing at Bits and Bobs most of his career, until the story goes one of his good friends in the Fender custom shop left. And he was like, oh man, I really enjoyed making guitars with this guy and working with this guy, and they kind of had a shake-up in the company. So Fender was like, I'm a prominent musician and I know enough about guitars. to kind of take this guitar to the next level. So he collaborated with Mr. Paul Reed Smith. This is a Silver Sky, and did that sound any different to you? Does that sound more Mayery to you than what the 62 reissue did? Both very fancy, expensive guitars. This one has his name on, but that's more akin to what he was used to. What sounds more Mayery? That's part of the fun of this video. See what you prefer. You might be a big Mayer fan, but not like the sound of the PRS, because it does sound quite different. So, when John left Fender in 2013, from 2014, 14, he'd been seen with some PRS guitars. Definitely not this, nothing like this. And they collaborated on the Silver Sky, this amazing John Mayer signature model for 2018, I believe. He'd been seen with it, teased in pictures on tours, a Strat, the PRS headstock. This was one of the most controversial guitars to come out of the past 800 years, let's say, because it's a Strat with a PRS headstock. It is. Brands like Sir and Tom Anderson and all that, even Schecter, do Strat copies. No one bats an eyelid. Because it's John Mayer and he's a very popular, awesome blues guy, everyone's like, that's just a Strat with their PRS headstock. It is, but if you notice, the PRS headstock is upside down. Normally the big bit is at that end, and now it's at that end, to kind of give it more of a Strat-y feel. Because when you play a lot of guitars like I do working in a music store, you can tell the difference between six aside headstocks and three and three. This sounds like a Strat and feels like a Strat, but the tension on the neck is quite unique and different, and with flipping it, it gives that G string the longest tension out of all of them to make it more akin to a Strat. But yes, the body is very similar. There's a little cutaway so you can get the higher frets, which is fantastic. Alder body, maple neck, a lovely, it's based off a 64 really, 64 profile neck, 7 1/4 inch radius fingerboard, so it's got quite a vintage style curve on it, but that certainly doesn't mean you can't play it fast and amazing. Locking tuners, quirky knobs and quirky kind of things. Everything's kind of bulbous and raised to kind of make, give it a modern look. It's a modern equivalent to the Strat. If you wonder why all the numbers are off here, because this guitar is my good friend Louis Ewan Clemenson's guitar, and he plays it a lot. And the pickups, what are they called again? 635 JMs. John Mayer pickups solely for the Silver Sky. Please make them PRS, because everyone will buy them, including myself. They're a high definition Strat pickup. Have they got the mid scoop in? Maybe, but they sound amazing. Some clean sounds in a second, but yes, all positions including the bridge pickup. Somewhere John doesn't really lie much, but he's aware if he's going to make a new signature guitar that the bridge pickup has to be tolerable, because sometimes Strat bridge pickups, especially vintage sounding Strat bridge pickups, can be very brittle, very bright and somewhat unpleasant. So the bridge pickup on this guitar, it's still a single coil, but it hasn't got a lot of unpleasant bite to it. And it cleans up beautifully as well. Let's hear it with a clean sound now, because we can. Actually, because we're in modern Mayer, the J-Mod 100 came out, his beautiful amplifier with PRS, which is weird, but it's totally, no one was kind of expecting it, but it came out. Because John had been rocking the Super Eagle, his £12,000 Jerry Garcia replica guitar that says PRS on the headstock, to get through the Dead and Company songs with all his crazy sounds. But everyone was shocked when the J-Mod £7,000 head didn't come with reverb. So he used the Flint. And this is what a Flint sounds like. Thank you. So it's a lovely kind of reverb. It's trying to make some of the best pedals under the sun. So if John's gonna choose a reverb pedal, he wants it to sound great, doesn't he? This guitar does play and sound amazing though. He kind of designed this to be a high definition version of a Strat. Vintage Strats are amazing. But what if he took that ethos, instead of making it modern the way Fender do with the Player Series and the amazing American Pro Range, what if you take it a step further? What if Skynet built Strats? They'd be amazing Strats. So, I think that's all the chat I've got. There might not be enough air left in this room to talk about such a small amount of John Mayer's rig, but those are the main guitars, why he uses certain pedals, and what you can do to achieve something similar to his tone yourself. It's not hard to find this stuff. It's very hard to find Dumbles and Two Rocks and stuff, especially in the UK. They hardly exist unless you're a multi-billionaire, and if so, can you buy me a Dumble, please? But yes, those are the guitars, besides all the other guitars, he's played, like I said, 61 reissue SGs, Music Man Reflexes, a 64 reissue Eric Clapton, Crossroads 335 for certain songs, and everything in between. He loves the new PRS 594s. Dude's got lots of guitars. Check out John Mayer Gear page on Instagram for all this kind of stuff. And I love that guy. And if you've enjoyed me talking, please give this video a like, because it's been a lot of fun to do and a lot of time to talk about all the Mayer stuff that's constantly going around in my head. If you want to add anything, feel free to down below. And I wasn't going to play any Mayer because of copyright, but I don't care. This has been a lot of fun to do. So, ladies and gentlemen, that is it. I hope you enjoyed that. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTVUK on YouTube for lots more guitar and music-related content. If you want any more information on any of the gear I've used today, get yourself to pmtonline.co.uk or call into one of our forever-expanding stores. We've got gear guides, we've got everything on the website, blogs, we've done AC/DC gear guides, the 1975, a few more, so check out the blogs and our videos on the gear guides. They're a lot of fun to do and I hope you enjoy them. We are PMT House of Rock on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook. Give us a like and a follow to see pictures of all these stuff but with nice filters on. I've been Dagan, and I'll see you next time.